Small business has been thrown a lifeline with the federal government planning new rules to let them trade out of insolvency. It's a stark contrast to some of the 35,000 Australians stranded overseas who today accuse their nation of abandoning them.
A Senate committee sees the human face of Australia's international border closure.
They are not stranded. They are abandoned by the government.
Peter's husband went to Serbia in July to care for his mother after his dad died suddenly. Like 35,000 other Australians, the cap on international returns has locked them out.
Our government have shamefully washed their hands of those citizens.
In the United Kingdom, Deanne Vowles also feels her nation is guilty of an intimate betrayal.
It just feels like a long-term boyfriend cheating on me.
Used to be that this passport meant something.
Labor blames the federal government.
Start the planes, send the planes out and bring these stranded Australians home.
National Cabinet has agreed to lift the caps on international returns by 1,600 to about 6,000 a week, based on
the amount of quarantine places that the states and territories are willing to provide.
The government did throw a lifeline to one group today, the thousands of businesses facing bankruptcy because of COVID-19 shutdowns.
A single, simpler, faster, more cost-effective insolvency process for small business.
Businesses with less than $1 million in debts will be allowed to keep trading for 20 days while developing a debt restructuring plan. All due employee entitlements must be paid before creditors vote on the plan, which will be binding if more than 50% agree. The $1 million threshold will cover about 76% of all insolvencies. And the Treasurer has laid down a marker for how long government spending to support the economy will last.
Until the unemployment rate is comfortably back under 6%.
That might take a while. Chris Ullman, Nine News.